And time for us to head to federal politics. A cabinet reshuffle is deemed to be necessary for the Morrison government, maybe to put to bed some of what's been a fairly ordinary time in the last month, albeit I think a focus that that needs to go back onto our country rather than the media and the frenzy focusing on the wrong things. John McDonnell, though, has this to say about the reset for Scott Morrison, and with about 12 months before an election and about a month to the budget, it is a very important time for his government to take stock of where it is. His article today on Flow News 24 says the dogs have been barking all week that Christian Porter and Linda Reynolds are going to lose their portfolios, although they may remain in cabinet. However, it now appears that the reshuffle will be more extensive than that, as the Prime Minister attempts to regain the trust of women who have come to the view that he's not interested in their concerns. I might add just on that, I haven't heard that to be the case in country areas at all. In fact, I've said the exact opposite to that particular point. I think that might be women journalists in Canberra and so on, and you know, that sort of a group of people that are pushing for an agenda, but I haven't actually picked that up in country areas at all. In Question Time on Wednesday, the Prime Minister deliberately left the question of Christian Porter's future in doubt. He responded to the Leader of the Opposition, Anthony Albanese, by saying that the Solicitor General had provided him with a report on possible conflicts of interest in the event that Mr. Porter retained his position of Attorney General while running a defamation action against the ABC. Mr. Morrison said that he was reviewing the report with the Secretary and Deputy Secretary of his department in the light of the ministerial standards. Also on Wednesday, the Minister for Defence, Linda Reynolds, advised that she would be unable to attend defence discussions in India on April the 13th because of medical advice. In the circumstances, it is considered unlikely that she will be able to continue on as a Minister for Defence, although it is not obvious what alternative cabinet position she could take. The current word is, and John says that McCallie Cash that will take over as Attorney General in a straight swap with Christian Porter, who will become Minister for Industrial Relations and Employment, and Peter Dutton would replace Linda Reynolds as Minister for Defence. It is unlikely that Senator Reynolds will take on the challenging portfolio of Home Affairs, but it is not clear what job she will get. And on the change that the Prime Minister is set to make, it is to appoint a standalone Minister for Women. The appointee would need to be someone who is willing to engage with women and the media in a way that Marie Payne had failed to do. There appears to be no senior Liberal women who are available and suitable, so he may have to appoint one of his younger group of Liberal women. And the article continues with details of the ongoing saga with Brittany Higgins and the Prime Minister's response to developments yesterday. You can read the rest of that at flownews24.com.au. And there are some really good candidates. There's some terrific young women senators in the Liberal and Coalition ranks, and maybe that's where the recruiting ground will come from, a younger woman. And look, I'm also concerned about this continued focus on, in effect, the private lives of people. And when one considers that there is dirt that can be thrown on the opposition, you can see this just deteriorating. If the opposition were to be elected at the next federal election, there would have to be recriminations for Anthony Albanese and his team. These sorts of things are not on one side of politics. And when you talk to folk in Parliament Houses, John McDonnell and also our other Canberra Bureau staff are aware of, it really is quite disturbing that this is the one side of the story that we're getting continually barraged with a fairly left-orientated press in Canberra, you have to say. But sadly, we aren't hearing the balance of this particular discussion from the opposition ranks and the Greens and others too. There is, quite frankly, more to what is happening here, and it is not focusing on running this country. It's not focusing on foreign policy. It's not focusing on economic development. It's not focusing on rural and agricultural needs. It's not focusing on manufacturing. It's focusing on something that really is actually got the limited value, particularly if the opposition, who are quite happy for it to be the focus, if they were to be in government themselves and this was to have the tables turned. And that's the key question here. This is the sort of the gutter politics that the public actually aren't interested in. They're quite frankly over it and looking forward to governance of the nation. The problem is that the ALP has set a course which is going to see recriminations on them at some time in the future.